La Torre's cousin.
Yeah, he is.
Uncle, sorry.
Pita, read this first question. It's in Spanish. I don't even know what they're asking.
Right all the way at the bottom or all the way at the top?
All the way on the top.
¿Dónde van a ser los pinches chingados?
Wow, they're asking where Mikey's fight's going to be.
What are they asking?
I'm guessing they're asking where Mikey's fight's going
to
be.
We don't know yet. To be determined. Will you ever see Lomachenko against Mikey? Lomachenko versus Mikey. Would that ever happen? You think so?
Yes.
How do you see that fight unfolding?
It's a good fight. Lomachenko's a great fighter. Great fighter, but Mikey, I think Mikey's too big for him, too strong for him. But yeah, still a good fight. Great fight.
What is Mikey gonna do different to deal with Broner's size?
Be in good shape, man. Be in good shape. Pita's won't give him the drinks.
Pita Fitness. Okay, next question. If Mikey beats Broner, will that open up the door for Crawford Mikey?
Of course it is. Of course it will. For many other fights.
Okay, if Mikey fights Crawford, does he train for a southpaw or orthodox?
We train for a short guy.
Yeah. Train for a small guy. Small guy. 500 punches around and puts pressure.
That's Crawford?
Exactly.
GGG versus Canelo, Robert. GGG versus Canelo.
It's a good fight, man. I want Canelo. I pick Canelo because that's Mexican, but it's a tough fight. It's a good fight for both. Great fight.
Can you, a Pita, teach fighters the shoulder roll?
No. No, we don't.
What did Mikey buy with his first big paycheck?
House.
The house party?
What did you buy with your first?
McDonald's. After his last fight, that's the first thing he went to McDonald's. Oh yeah, they had an after party set up for him, and everybody was at the after party. Everyone was at the after party, and Mikey was snapping that he was eating a Big Mac.
And who's the one that bought like 100 McChickens or what?
Melos. We did that with him.
What did you do with your first? Buy a car, a house, jewelry?
I bought my Navigator.
Where's the Navigator now?
In 98. I gave it to Donald.
Isn't he in Morocco?
Yeah.
Did he take it with him to Morocco?
Well, that wasn't the Navigator I gave Donald. I had a white Navigator in 98. In 98, I bought my Navigator. It was a white one.
You were the first one in Oxnard with it?
I was the first one. The first one and only one in Oxnard. Nowadays, everybody has all those cars. But yeah, back in the day, in 98, I had the white Navigator. And then a couple years later, I traded in and got the burgundy one.
That's the one
I gave Donald.
And he had a license plate, IBF champ.
IBF champion.
So yeah. Donald's now IBF champ.
Well, he's changed it. He gave me the plate. I got the plate.
Okay. Will Josecito Lopez versus Brandon Rios ever happen?
I wouldn't want that to happen. I really wouldn't.
You're friends with Brandon and you train Josecito?
I'm training Josecito, so I really wouldn't want that to happen.
Ask Robert if he could teach Mikey to break the shoulder roll defense.
I can't.
It's impossible.
You already had a lot of experience. Two Mayweather fights, Broner fight.
No, we can't. We don't know how.
Adriano wants a shout out.
Adriano.
De Oros.
Adriano de Oro. Saludos, Adriano de Oro. Hey, Lupe, who's your biggest, who's your newest client lately?
Lupe has big clients?
Robert Garcia.
Oh, you're working with him now?
Of course.
Are you giving advice to everybody?
Yeah.
So, Lupe, if people want to hire you...
advice for Robert Garcia.
If people want to hire you for your services, because you are one of the best lawyers in the United States of America, how do they get a hold of you?
They call Ali Setback, as they say. How do I get a hold of Guadalupe Valencia?
Does it have to be epic major cases, like 15 million and up, for you to handle them? Or?
Not a DUI for sure.
Yeah, not a DUI. You got to at least kill two or three people.
It has to be major. Major crime unit?
As long as it's two or three homicides, a couple tons of...
What if you embezzle and you steal... What if you embezzle...
$10 million or more.
Look, I know a lot of people that do like healthcare fraud and they steal like $100 million from the government and get caught. Should they call you?
Sometimes.
Okay. No, they get a fine and then they get out of jail 2 years later with all the money. They never are asked to pay back what they stole.
Bro, and listen, one thing that I've learned over many years is that the criminal justice system shouldn't be called criminal justice system. It should be called the criminal processing system. It's an arbitrary system. There's no consistency. depending on where you get arrested, you know, what your financial resources are, you know, there's so many factors involved. It's,
you can't predict the result when you start.
The only thing is, there's a couple important things. Save money and call your lawyer as soon as you get arrested.
Who's the number one pound for pound fighter today?
Number one pound for pound fighter. I don't think there's a single one, but I think there's a few. And I think Mikey Garcia is definitely in the top pound for pound. Since he's come back, he's been, you know, flawless, you know, amazing. But there's a lot of good, you know, Crawfords up there. I think, you know, Andrew Ward, people, you know, he's not a knockout puncher, but he's an amazing fighter. There's a lot of good fighters.
Robert, who's pound for pound king right now?
I don't think there's one that you could probably say that's the guy that has to be, because Canelo has done really good. Triple G's been doing really good. Ward, Kovalev,
Mikey
Lomachenko, Crawford. So there's not that one that you say that, like when Mayweather was or when De La Hoya was. You know, that one that's been dominating and deserves to be called number one. There's quite a few. And a lot of people have different, everybody has a different opinion on the pound fighter.
Opinions are like assholes. Everyone, and they all stink. But that's what pound for pound list is, someone's opinion.
Yeah, that's what it is.
All right. You know, Ellie, I think that right now, all the weight divisions from 135 to 147 are really exciting.
Yeah.
Especially the welterweight division.
Big fights coming up.
Big fights. Huge fights.
No, boxing is a good place right now compared to 5 years ago and 6 years ago.
Yes, it is.
Because right now, you know, you have a lot of really elite fighters, a lot of good fighters. You know, there's a lot of action right now. And a lot of these top fighters right now haven't fought each other. So there's an opportunity for all these guys to fight each other, you know, over the next couple of years.
Hopefully it happens.
And they look like they are fighting each other, so that's good. It's good for boxing.
All right, there you have it. Lupe Valencia, look him up. Please do the point that comes, let's see back reporting.